Throw a ball at a slight angle upwards and it will go further than if you threw it parallel to the ground. But if the angle is too much, it won't go further. This video will show you how to code the projectile motion simulator. I know my channel is about computer programming, but this gravity simulator requires some physics knowledge. No tool? Great. Skip to the timestamp on the screen. Now that no one's showing off anymore, let's make sure that you humble viewers understand what I'm talking about. The last bit I want complicated this experiment is air resistance, so it's zero. Also, according to Newton's second law, acceleration equals force divided by mass, so the resultant speed is 50 meters per second. And if you know through that, great, skip to the timestamp on the screen. If not, displacement means the shortest distance from the starting point to the ending point possible, which is as distant as a crow flies. Initial velocity means the velocity that the object began with in a given time frame. Final velocity means the velocity that the object ended up with in a given time frame. Acceleration means the rate of change of velocity, and time means the length of progress of existence. Those are the definitions of all the subscripts and symbols. The initial x velocity is the initial velocity times the cosine of theta. Likewise, the initial y velocity is the initial velocity times the sine of theta. It would be better if you saw the velocity time graphs here first, so that you could understand it better. Although you could use integrals to calculate the area under the curve, it would be much simpler to calculate the area under the curve using basic geometrical knowledge. For the anti-calculus people, I have put up velocity time graphs for each direction, x velocity being at the left and y velocity being on the right. With the information on the slides and knowledge of finding the area of a rectangle and a triangle, you get to skip calculus and find the area under the curve, or rather, the lines. For the y velocity time graph, there is a negative area under the curve component if the area desired is not under the curve, but over the curve. But it's still called area under the curve. The slides say it's all. I'm going to leave the full integral solutions unsolved, as for the x integral distance, it will answer a future question in the video, but I will leave it a surprise. For the y integral, it will equal zero. Trust me. If you don't, find it out for yourself. Substitute time with the upper and lower bounds of the integral and find the difference between the two. If you know your math, I'm sure the value will equate to zero. The slide says it's all about how we will implement the code of bouncing the ball multiple times. Let's get coding! The comments explain all of the configuration commands in the code so that I don't have to waste your time. This converter is necessary because the math trig functions take values in radians, but in this experiment, we take values in degrees. If you don't understand, remember, 180 degrees is pi radians. The first half of this initialization function of the ball is the variable defining part. And the second half is the ball turtle settings. The file name is an image of the turtle, which is a tennis ball. The image has to be in the same folder as the code file in order for this to work. These are the displacement equations represented in computer code. The displacement equations translate to the coordinates of the ball at that time, which is why I left the integral equations unsolved at the stage I left it at. If you're confused, if the value of this equation is zero, then the ball is at the peak of the bounce trajectory. I'm just going to give you some time to read all my comments for this part of the code. And that's bouncing done. Now, we're going to do the bounce experiments. I'm going to give you time to digest all this information. Here, for the data output, the commands speak for themselves.
But wait. Here, self.b.setsy coordinate minus 50.
Is that going to affect the code?
Because then it will just shift the bounce to that coordinate.
Well, actually, no. That will be okay because there's this function
which will cancel that out and will mean that it will bounce from the right place and not from 50 pixels south of where it should be.
So that's problem solved. In classical science experiments, it's always necessary to have some results to see how far the ball went.
And I'm going to show you this just so that you can see. And let's see what results this code could bring us. So those are all the results that we could get from here, and I'm going to close this so that we could display the results on the disabled physical graph here. They're more accurate. Alright. At 30 degrees and 60 degrees angles, traveling the same distance of 433 meters. And so the 75 and 15, and 90 and 0. 45 degrees went the furthest. So the last part of the video is answering why.
Here I use a double angle formula as part of my calculations. There is also a substitution of initial velocity y by initial velocity times sine of theta. And this slide says the rest. The reason why the slope equation, the derivative of a displacement equation, must equal zero is due to the theorem of a necessary condition for the existence of a local extreme. In addition to this, the inverse cosine function is a function outputting a value, where if that value is inputted into a cosine function, it would output the value originally inputted into the cosine function. Essentially, it's an operator reversing the cosine operator. That's how every inverse operations work, from adding and subtracting to multiplying and dividing to squares and square roots. The slide says it all. I would let you read the slide and then that's it for the video. If you would like to see something cooler than gravity, check out my black hole drawing with Python Turtle, because black holes have the strongest gravitational fields.